that sickle cell has such a does very common sense. It doesn't get above a certain frequency in human population. It gets to a frequency where homozygous for individuals with two copies of the sickle allele starts to become common, and that leads to this further increase in the frequency of that effect. So surrogates are always going to find non-sickle individuals from sex, and so they don't in a sense have to evolve around that predictive mechanism. That's a great question, and so in an individual that has one sickle copy of the hemoglobin and one wild type copy, but does have a more normal phenotype, and exactly how resistance is conferred by this heterozygous state of having one sickle version and one wild type version is not fully understood. It's thought that perhaps having a little bit of an altered shape could allow the spleen, for example, more effective. We're still figuring out the biology of even these resistance mechanisms that we've associated with malaria for 50 years. So I think the best example is in this Anopheles gambi complex. So Anopheles gambi, this very important vector in Africa, as I mentioned, has a sister species that's completely identical, called Anopheles quadrangulatus, and this is a species that prefers to bite cows or ungulates over humans. So this is extremely recent.